stunning development in the battle to rescue Virgin Australia. The Queensland Government planning its own bid to buy the airline and keep its headquarters and jobs in Brisbane. But Federal Home Affairs Minister Peter Dutton has really stirred up controversy, calling the plan laughable. And to discuss, I'm joined by Tasmania Senator Jacqui Lambie, who's in Canberra this morning, and Stella Magazine's Sarah Lamarquand. Good morning. How are you both?
Good morning. Thank you.
Jacqui, I want to start with you because, I mean, I totally get why Queensland Government wants to save jobs, but this airline has made losses for 7 years straight, almost $2 billion, and we're talking about taxpayer money here. Does this make any sense to you, or is it a PR stunt?
Well, I think we need that competition in the skies. There's no doubt about that. Otherwise, you can imagine Alan Joyce and his executives up in Qantas, they'll be coming for more cash. There's no doubts about that. But what's really, really worrying is if this airline completely goes down, we're going to be paying over $800 million in entitlements anyway. I think it's in the best interest of all the states and the nation to go in there and have a bit of a look and see whether it's worth investing, because one airline flying around in this country, no way. And if you want tourism and that to pick up, the cost of those flights is going to be phenomenal. I can tell you that there's not going to be bargaining going on. And if people can't afford to fly, then tourism's not going to pick up again. So what's the other option? The other option is we start from scratch and invest in a brand new airline. There's just no common sense here. And I don't know if anyone from federal government's actually gone and had a good look at this. But really, I think they should leave it open and go and have a look at it on the table.
Hang on, but would you be okay with the state government running an airline in this country?
No, what I think is the best thing to do is that all the states should have an interest in this, and whether it's shares and the nation, and make sure that we have competition flying in our skies. Because right now, only having one, I don't think is going to be, certainly not going to suffice for the future. And like I said, can you imagine the price hikes that are going to go on when you've got no competition in the skies? That's terribly worrying. And I'll tell you, people aren't going to fly around. They'll just stay in their states.
What are your thoughts on this one, Sarah?
I think it's completely unrealistic, unfortunately, that the Queensland government would be able to afford this. We're talking about billions and billions of dollars as a price tag. It's completely unrealistic. But as Jacqui said, you completely understand why Queensland government feels so strongly about this. We, as a country, we cannot afford to go back to a one carrier. We have to have two airlines. And for Queensland, the ramifications would be catastrophic if Virgin were to fold. But I also agree with Jacqui that it's not very helpful, the federal government just shrugging this off. And Peter Dutton didn't just say this was laughable. He also accused the Queensland government of being corrupt and chaotic. Now, I just don't think there's any appetite among voters at the moment for that sort of partisan mudslinging. We want to see our leaders showing genuine leadership and as Jacqui said, coming to the table and talking through things in a practical way.
Yeah, it was nice to see the Queensland Treasurer. He didn't hold back. Cameron Dick, he hit Twitter as well. And what did he say? Stick to cruise ships.
Exactly. It's all a bit unseemly, isn't it? I mean, it's funny, but come on.
I just love politics is back. It's great.
The peace is over. The peace is over.
Absolutely. Now, you can almost hear the ripple of cheers across the country this morning because our pubs and clubs, they are about to reopen. But there is going to be a serious limit to the fun. New South Wales will allow just 10 customers at a time. Other states, they have pretty similar or even more slightly more lenient rules, with only Victoria still bone dry. Jacqui, I mean, we need something to celebrate, don't we?
Yeah, it's time for a beer, there's no doubt about that. But I think, look, a lot of these clubs and pubs are saying, and especially in the rural and regional areas, to have 10 patrons, they can't open their doors, they're not making any money. And that's really, really sad. So for many of them, they won't be able to open their doors. So we won't be going in for a beer this weekend, I don't think. How they get around that, I'm not sure. Look, the best thing that we can do is try and eradicate this virus so we can get on and have our Sunday sessions. There's no doubt about that. And I'm sure Carl will be in for that.
Yeah, he's champing at the bit, and you know it. But that's the thing, isn't it, Sarah? I mean, I can't imagine there's going to be too much atmosphere with only 10 people at the pub.
Oh, it depends. You could, you know, get 9 of your mates around and have a great old time. It's like a big
socially
private
distancing
dining room. That's true. Look, I mean, it's my 15th wedding anniversary today, so surely come the weekend.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. So obviously we can't do much today, but by the weekend there's got to be a bowl of chips and gravy with my name on it, don't you think, down at the local pub?
And hey, a party for two's all right.
That's always good with a party for two. Look, I feel sorry for big restaurants. It is obviously very difficult for them, and it's not going to have any immediate effect. But look, I know we've said it before, and it's such an unsatisfying answer, but we've got to play the long game here. And it's baby steps, and hopefully by early June we'll be able to see these numbers grow, and that will really see a huge revival as we all help the hospitality sector rebuild.
And we know there's now this push that by July 1 to actually open up our borders between states in time for the school holidays. How would you feel about that, Jacqui? A whole plane load full of interstaters coming down to see you in Tassie?
Yeah, we have been the epicentre. I don't think they're going to be rushing back to Tasmania, unfortunately. No, I'm just kidding. Look, yeah, I think if those numbers start to continue to reduce, that's fabulous. But we're going to have to still be really, really careful. I'm really concerned about the testing. I can tell you now, I've walked into Parliament House, haven't seen one temperature test, haven't seen anything about testing. People getting in comm cars in the front, not in the back. So I just think everyone's become really, really relaxed really quickly since Mother's Day, and this is not the way to play the long game. Otherwise, we're going to end up back behind closed doors, and that's the last thing the economy or anybody else needs. So please, for people out there, it's not over by a long shot, and you have to stick to that social distancing, stick to the rules and regulations. Otherwise, we're going nowhere, and we're just going to be going around in circles.
Hey, that's a real worry that you're talking about there, Jacqui, that our politicians in Canberra aren't doing the right thing.
No, so we're crossing borders, and, we're crossing borders. There's no testing going on up here. Supposed to be leading by example, no temperature testing, no nothing. It's actually blowing me away. I think, oh, my goodness me. So that's a worry in itself, especially when you have the most important man in the country, which is your own Prime Minister, up here, and people are seeing him, and there's no testing going on. It really bothers me.
Sitting next to the Treasurer having a coughing fit, who did test negative, we should point out. Hey, ladies, thanks for joining us this morning. Really appreciate it.